the world, but he couldn't fill man's empty praise. The treasures that fade were never enough. But then you came along and you put me back together. Now every desire is now satisfied here in your love. Lord, there's nothing better than you. There's nothing better than you, Lord. There's nothing, nothing is better than you. The God of the valley, and there's not a place your mercy and grace won't find me again. Lord, there's nothing better than you. There's nothing better than you. Oh, there's nothing better than better than you. Lord, there's nothing better than you. I searched this world, but y'all, I couldn't find nothing better. Oh, nothing is better than you. Turn mourning to dancing. You give beauty for ashes. You turn shame into glory. You're the only one who can. Oh, you turn praise into garden. You turn bones into army. Turn seas into highways. You're the only one who can. You're the only one who can. Lord, there's nothing better than you. There's nothing better than you, Lord. There's nothing. Nothing is better than you. Turn seas into highways. You're the only one who can. You turn graves into gardens. You turn bones into armies. You turn seas into highways. Powerful. That's the kind of power that is in the Lord. What I also love is that there's power in his presence, but then there's a gentle and a mighty and a beautiful love that we can tap into in his presence. And so in this song, I just want to sing of tapping deeper into the presence of the Lord, of connecting deeper with the God who loves us and who cares so deeply for us, that we can spend time with him and invest our lives and invest our time into getting to know who he is. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. You love us. Help us to love you back.
Oh, you love us. Help us to love you back. Time stands still. Whenever I'm with you, there's no more important place to go. There's no rush. I'm not in a hurry. It's okay to take it slow. The minutes turning into hours. Does it really matter? The only one I'm after. Spirit, come in power. I just want you. Only you.
All we want is you.
All we want is you.
All we want is you. Lord, forgive me, I've been too busy trying to do this on my own. Your embrace is what I've been missing,
and I don't wanna let it go.
Minutes turning into hours. Does it really matter? I just want you.
You're the one I'm after.
You're the only one I'm after. Spirit, come in power. I just want you.
I just want you, Lord.
I just want you. Nothing compares to you. Nothing comes close. I just want you. I just want you. Nothing compares to you. Nothing comes close.
Oh, nothing comes close to your presence. Oh.
Fragrance
of your presence, I could get used to.
Does it really matter? I just want you.
You're the only one I'm after.
You're the only one I'm after.
Spirit, come.
Spirit, come.
You, we thank you for the power of your presence. I thank you, God, that you would raise our awareness of your presence, God. Make us sensitive to the fact that you are in this room. You are right here among us, and you care so deeply about us, the heaviness of our hearts, the concerns of our hearts. Some of us, Mother's Day is a day of rejoicing and a day of celebration. But for others, it's a day of mourning and sadness. But I thank you, God, that with your presence, there is joy in mourning. That mourning, even mourning in the sense of sadness, that mourning can be turned to dancing when we're with you, God. Because there's joy in your presence, Lord. There's joy in knowing that you are present, that you are real, and that you deeply care about the concerns of our hearts. And so I pray now, God, that we open up our hearts to you. Can we say that? God, I open my heart to you. I open up my heart to you. Whatever it is that you want to teach, I want you guys to pray this as I'm praying it. Whatever it is that you want to teach us today, let us learn it. Whatever it is, whatever message that you have for us today, God, let us be able to receive it. Let our hearts be open. Let our minds be open to you and close to everything else in this moment, in this day, in this time. It's for you, God. And so we cut out everything else, we block out everything else, and we lean into the Creator, our Lord, our Savior, our Father, and our friend. And we say yes to you. We say have your way in any way that you want to, because I already feel that your spirit wants to move. And so we just say yes to you, Lord, and we thank you for who you are. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. Amen.
Amen, amen, amen. How many of you all in this room, you all just, you're open to receiving what the Lord has for you? How many people, you're open to receiving what the Lord has for you? You all just close your eyes, just lift your hands real quick. Just close your eyes, lift your hands real quick. Thank you, Lord. We invite your spirit, we invite your presence. Thank you that you are here. You have your way, Lord. We come against anything right now that may be trying to distract, anything that would try to block or hinder, Lord. We honor you in this place today, Lord. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen. 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 How many of you all in this room, you love Jesus? Who loves Jesus in this room? Let me see who loves Jesus. Make some noise if you love Jesus in this room. See, that don't even really sound like it. I said make some noise if you love Jesus in this room. Open up your mouth if you love him. Make some noise. Amen, amen. How many people love their mothers? Make some noise if you love your mamas in this room. Amen, amen. How many people in here, you love the Lakers? Make some noise if you love the Lakers in this room. Not a lot of that. All righty, all righty, all righty. Well, good morning, good morning, good morning. Y'all make some noise for the praise team. Y'all make some noise for Plug Worship. Great job, you all. Great job. You all can go and head back to your seats. Before you all sit down, welcome. My name is Nehemiah, youth pastor here at The Plug. And welcome to The Plug, where? I said, welcome to The Plug, where?
People get linked up to God.
All right, good, good, good. Stand on up. Everybody, nobody sit down yet. Wait a sec. We stand. Stand up. Yeah, stand up on them feet. All right, good, good. Well, I'm excited. Happy Mother's Day. Today could be a day that can be very joyous because we love our mothers. We celebrate our mothers. Who brought their moms a gift? Who brought a gift? Who bought something? Like, you spent your own money. Who spent more than $50? Ooh. That's cap, but who spent more than $100 on their mama? Hey, what'd you buy your mom? A necklace? Oh, that's sweet. You spent, okay, good, good, good. Today could be a day where it could be very joyous and celebratory, but also it could be a day that could be very sad as well. If we think about it, some people, they don't have good relationships with their moms. There's some people who don't know their parents or know their mom at all, but... Or you might have lost your mother. And so really, today is a day where we want to reflect and give thanks for our mothers that we do have. We want to give thanks as well, even if something has happened and we don't have a good relationship, because ultimately, God is the best parent of all. Who feels like their parents are like really, really good? Who feels like they got good parents, right? Is your mom, your parents good? They done anything wrong before? Never? Never? Not that you know of. Dang, I need to meet your parents. I thought I had good parents. I mean, I had good parents, but they did wrong. Like, you ain't never got whooped for never doing nothing you ain't did wrong? Oh, man, your parents are just too good. All right, don't worry. Bad example. Huh? Have you ever gotten in trouble for something that you've never done? Nah? Who? Anybody else? Like, okay, see, okay. Y'all got realistic parents. This guy got, you got great parents. That's really good, though. Most parents, even though they're really good, most parents that are really good, they still make mistakes, right? The beautiful thing about God is God has never made a mistake. And even if you are in a place of mourning, God is here with you. You know, his spirit wants to be here with you just to comfort those who have broken hearts, all right? Amen? Amen, amen. So I wanted to play a little game real quick. A little true or false, is it real, is it fake? The questions I'm going to ask, one winner will win at the end, okay? If you win, I got something for you. If you lose, you get nothing, all right? Nothing at all. So this is how it goes. Free tickets to the power trip. Not for this, no. Not for this game. Absolutely not. Thank you. All right, so this is how it's going to go. If you think the question is true, stand up. If you think the question is true, put one hand up. If you think it's false, put two hands up. If you get it right, you'll continue standing. If you get it wrong, sit that butt down, okay? Let's get to it. First question. Bing. Get some other ones up. Give me another one. Pink and red carnations are to be given to mothers still living, while white carnations are for those mothers who have passed. Is this real or fake? Is it true or false? True or false? One hand is true, two hands are false. Let me see. What do I think? I think that's false. I ain't gonna lie. That gotta be false. All right, let's see. Oh, dang. If you got it wrong, sit down. Sit down if you got it wrong. Don't lie either. You in church, don't lie. All y'all got that right? All right, let's go to the next one. Approximately $14 billion is spent on Mother's Day each year in the United States alone. Is that true or false? $14 billion, that's like a B. Like, not million, $14 billion. Like, y'all think true? And okay, let's see what we got. That's crazy. That got to be false. Whoa. Dang. Sit down. Dang. I would have got that wrong. I ain't going to lie. $14 billion? That's a lot of money. All right, let's go to the next one. In Yugoslavia, on Mother's Day, the children would tie the mother up, and the only way she was freed was if she gave her children treats. Is this true or false? Is this true or false? This got to be true. This got to be true. All right, let's see. All right, what we got? True. Sit down. Dang. Most of y'all. Okay, we got a couple people left. Okay. All right, let's see, let's see, let's see. Mother's Day is celebrated in 250 countries worldwide. Is that true or false? It's true or false? False? Hurry up, hurry up. All right, let's see. Fake. Sit down. Do we have a... Dang, we got a winner right here. Y'all make some noise one time. Make some noise. All right, see me after service. I got a gift card for you. All right, my boy, good job, good job. Dang, y'all salty because y'all lost? Y'all ain't make no noise for my man at all right? All right, cool, cool, cool. Well, let's get ready to jump in for today. Let's get ready to jump in for today. Who brought their Bibles to church? Who brought their Bibles to church? You got your, okay, one Bible, two Bibles. We got two Bibles in the building. No Bibles over here? Oh, you got your Bible? Put that Bible up in the air. Yeah, don't be shameful of that Bible. All right. Nah, that's not. That's a phone. Which has a Bible on it, which is cool. Offering time. Let's get ready. If you could turn to Deuteronomy chapter 8, verses 16 through 18. Deuteronomy 8, verses 16 through 18. Shh. All right, if you could go to verse 16, it says this. Who fed you in the wilderness? Actually, let me go back. This is about the children of Israel and God taking care of them. And he has some specific things that he wanted to tell them when he was out, when they were out in the wilderness. It says, who fed you in the wilderness with manna, which your fathers did not know, that he might humble you, and that he might test you to do good at the end. Then it says, then you say in your heart, my power and the might of my hand have gained me wealth. And you shall remember the Lord your God, for it is he who gives you the power to get wealth. This is the last, I want you all to focus on this. It says, for it is he who gives you the power to get wealth. Why do you think the Lord wants to give people power to get wealth? Why do you think that is? Why do you think that? And a lot of hands in the air. I'm not sure who to pick from, honestly. So many. Hands up. I guess I'll go with, okay, I'll go with you. Why? Yes, and Jerry, I'm just picking you out of everybody since everybody had him up. If you could get her real quick, why do you think God gives us the power to get wealth?
To see what people would do with it, because some people, once they get money, they flee away from God and don't do the right things or don't get closer to family and stuff. So I guess it's like a test to see what will happen once you
fix. Okay, to expose who you really are, to test you. That's a good one. Anybody else? Why do you think he gives us the power to get wealth? Why do you think?
To see how they'll use it.
See how you use it?
Yeah.
Expound. You're not sure? All right. this is one of the anybody else? Anybody else? Ask the question again. The scripture says it is God who gives us the power to get wealth. Why do you think the Lord gives us the power to attain wealth? Why do you think he gives us that power to attain wealth? All right, so listen. Oh, we got one more hand. Last one. Let's see. Come on, Sarah, come through.
So we can have it for our children.
So we can have it for our children. And their children and everybody else's children. That's a good point. I want us to think of it like this. God is a giver. Everything that you have on your body, in your whole body, is because of God, right? Think about it. The clothes come from plants or animals, right? You yourself, God created. God is abundant and gives freely, right? He wants us to have wealth so that we can be a blessing to other people as well. He wants us to be people who give, who are helping other people's needs, that seeing people downtrodden, broken, and be able to help them. Seeing a family that's not able to, you know, pay for groceries and you being able to do that. God wants to give us the power to get wealth so ultimately we can help others. It's not a selfish motive, but it should be for unselfish reasons only. And so we want to be people who want to be givers. We want to be people who want to bless people. Has anybody ever done that before? Like you bought somebody's meal before. Who's bought somebody a meal and they ain't have the money to be able to buy their own meal, right? Like it's a, how many people you feel good after you do that? Like it's a good feeling, right? Right? It does. It feels really good. Honestly, people think that the more money you get, the happier you'll get because you can spend more things on yourself. But ultimately, it comes from you being able to bless people, you'll be happier than you just buying things for yourself. Whenever you can bless somebody else and make somebody else's life better, it's always going to make your life better. It's just a weird kind of law that is in the earth. But there's a couple ways that we can give here. You can raise your hand if you need an offering envelope. You can also go online to linkedupchurch.com if you can get him an offering envelope real quick. And you can go to linkedupchurch.com as well. We always talk about 10% of whatever you get, you want to give back to the Lord as a blessing, as a thankfulness to say thank you to him. Or you can go to text the number right here. You can text 678-203-2500. Let me finish getting mine in. All right, perfect. Let's pray. Dear Heavenly Father, Lord, we thank you so much for the opportunity that we have to give. Thank you, dear Father God, that you are the one that gives us the power to attain wealth. Lord, we thank you for that power. We pray that we use that power to bring other people up, dear Father God, and not just exalt ourselves. We ask you, dear Father God, that you give us a heart of thanksgiving for all that you have done for our life. In Jesus' name we pray. If you agree, somebody say amen. Amen, amen, amen. Let's get ready to, you all can go ahead and pass those buckets, and as you pass those buckets, we'll get ready to jump into the message. Really quickly, who in here, your friends have ever gassed you up to do something that you know you shouldn't do? You ain't got no friends? Okay, praise the Lord. Hallelujah, you ain't got. How many people got friends that have gassed them up to do something stupid, right? I think most of us have, right? We're going to jump into this series called Gassed Up. Y'all pay attention to the screen, and let's get ready to jump in from there. All right?
Yes, come yes you're a queen.
All righty. So we're in this series called Gassed Up. Gassed Up. A lot of times, the scripture says pride cometh before a... Oh, some of you all know the scripture this service. All right, they ain't know that at all. Pride cometh before a fall, right? And what happens is people can be gassed up on the wrong thing, gassed up on pride, on ego, and they ended up falling just like Shorty that we just saw on the screen, right? Her friends was gassing her up. Girl, you a queen, Bob. Boom, right, and ended up falling. Who in here feels like they're called to be successful in life? Who's going to be successful? who feels like they're called to do great things in the world, right? I should really see everybody's hand up, right? Everybody is called to achieve a level of success or greatness, and success isn't just money. Success is like accomplishing what God has called you to do on this earth. So I'm going to ask that question again. Who in here feels like they want to be successful and they want to be great in life? Let me see. Good. Anytime you want to go on a far distance, when you want to travel somewhere, like in a vehicle, you need to have gas in the tank. Who drives? Who drives? An electric car, that's what you got? One of them little toy cars, right? One of them electric toy cars. That's good, man. You got battery, 16 volt. Good. Who in here, yo, fellas, y'all be pumping the gas for your moms? Yeah. Every time? All right. Some of y'all know? Yeah, I know some of y'all lying. What about your sisters?
My sister don't drive.
Oh, okay. Hey, all right, good. It's always a good thing to pump gas for your mom, all right, especially if she's driving, all right? Like, that's the least you can do. You ain't paying for it, all right? So, if you want to go far in life, you have to have the right type of fuel inside your tank. The proper fuel will determine how far you go. If you try to gas your tank up on milk, almond milk, you're not going to... You say, ew. Almond milk is... Bro, you're tripping. If you try to gas your tank up on almond milk, you're not going to go far at all because it's not the proper fuel. A lot of us in life, we're trying to go somewhere, but we don't have the right fuel inside of us. And so what we need to do is make sure that we gassing up on the right thing. And that thing that we need is the Spirit of God. It is His power. It's His power. So let's get ready to jump right in. Let's go to 2 Peter 1:2-4. All right, I'm going to need y'all to, like, move. I'm going to have to, yeah, you come on up here. Yeah, come on up. Yep, y'all, yeah. You and Summer come on up here. Yep, yeah, y'all come on up here. And then y'all, yeah, stay over there. Yeah, good. All right, cool. So 2 Peter 1:2-4. 2 Peter 1:2-4. Cool. When you get there, say amen. Boy, you ain't there yet. Lying in church.
I was already there.
2 Peter 1:2-4. All right, this is what it says. We're going to read on three. It's up on the screen. On three, we're going to read. Can y'all read?
Yes.
Good?
Maybe.
All right, let's go. 1, 2, 3. Grace and peace be multiplied to you in the knowledge of God and of Jesus our Lord. Let's go to verse 3. Was that too slow?
Yes.
I just felt like, all right, cool. Let's go to verse 3. This is the one I really want us to get, so we can say it a little quicker. 3, 2, 1, read. As His divine power has given to us all things that pertain to life and godliness, through the knowledge of Him who called us by glory and virtue. He's given us everything that pertains to what? Okay. Who said that? Life. He's given us all things that pertain to what? It's right there. He's given us all things, divine power, like, this says His divine power. That means God's, like, what makes Him God, the divinity, the majesty of God, like, in that power He has given to us for life and godliness. Anything that we need to have a good life, He's given us that power. Anything that we need to live godly, He has given us that power, which is like crazy that God Almighty has given us the same type of power that He has. Question, what are some of the things that you think you need God's power for in like everyday life, like you all's lives right now? Maybe let's say, some of you all's friends' life in case it's some, like, ratchet, right? Like, what are some things that you need God's divine power for your life for? Give me a couple answers. Let me see some hands raised. Let me get some answers. And, like, be honest, be vulnerable, be like, open with some of these things. We had some really good ones last service. I'll get, yep, oh, get him first. Well, she's right there. Go on, Sarah.
To get up in the morning, or, like, motivation to get up in the morning.
To get up in the morning? Okay. Who feels like that? Who feels like they don't like getting up in the morning? Like, you just be, like, you mean, like, now, do you mean, like, you just tired and you don't want to wake up? Or just, like, I don't feel like going nowhere, like, that, right? All right. I ain't going to lie. Sometimes it'd be very tough to wake up in the morning. Y'all be waking up early? Yeah, y'all got to catch the bus, right? Y'all got to catch the bus. 7:30? Boy, that's late. Boy, that's late. What do you mean? That man said, yeah, man, 7:30 in the morning. I got to, that's late. That's crazy, bro. Bro, you got it backwards. You're not supposed to sleep in during the week. You sleep in during the weekend. Anyway, what's another one? What's another one that you, like, God's divine power for life and godliness? For your life.
My life.
Well, you had your hand raised the whole time, and you ain't got nothing. All right, cook, my brother, as they say.
I'll probably say, like, putting in work to do things with a right attitude instead of, like, just, like you're doing work, but you're not giving it your all.
That's solid. All right, that's solid. I'm glad we let you cook. Anybody else? Nobody else needs God for anything in their life, huh? Like, what are some areas that you need God's power in your life for? Let me get Emilice right there. And then, I already got you. I'm trying to get other people. Say that again.
Like, boundaries with people, like, at school, family, like, boundaries.
Boundaries with people. Power to... Okay, so that, and when you say boundaries, I'm wondering, because when my mind went to that, like, boundaries of, like, you know, boundaries with the opposite sex, or you mean, like, friendship boundaries? What, like, elaborate for me some. Give her that. I'm interested to see.
Just, like, protecting myself from, like, what other people at my school do and everything, like, keeping myself safe from that, like, not, like, participating in different.
Okay, I think I'm following exactly what you're saying. Thank you. Anybody else? Yes.
I don't really know, like, necessarily, like, friendships.
Can you talk up for me?
like friendships.
Friendships. You need, okay, like, and are you saying that in the sense of, like, to break up with certain friends or to get the right type of friends or both?
I don't necessarily need to be friends with.
Okay. Well, that's good that you know that. Okay. That's really good that you know that. Yo, let's pray for her right now. Right? That she's like, oh my goodness, I should have never said anything. But Lord, we pray right now that you give her the power to eliminate those friends that she doesn't need to have in her life in the name of Jesus. Amen. Anybody else need that? Anybody else? Who else need that power to get rid of them bad friends in your life? Sometimes it's not even a whole bunch of power. You just need to pull out your phone and text them. I don't want to be friends. No, I'm just kidding. The courage to do it. I like that. Go on, Summer. Thank you, Sean, for waiting.
It's like relationships, like with, like, the opposite sex. Like, you have to have, like boundaries so you know how far you can go and, like, to stay away from, like, temptations with other people.
Yeah. Elijah said, you shouldn't be, don't worry about how far you can go. Don't go at all. because certain times though, in all seriousness though, there is no, like, You just don't need to be entertaining it, period. Like, don't entertain it. But that's it. I agree, though. We do need God's power in that. We do need God's power with that. Any last ones? Any other ones? Any other ones? For life in general. First service beating y'all right now. I ain't gonna lie. They beating y'all. Nah. All
right. I want to say education, because a lot of us get sidetracked by other stuff. Oh, I don't need to go to college because I could just get a job and go do this. But it's like, we can do it. We just need the strength to stay focused. And,
yeah. I like that. Can I reword it some? Okay. I like saying the strength to be able to do what God has called us to do, right? Because some people, it may not be education, but you probably is education, right? But the strength to be able to do what God has called us to do, I think that's a really good one. Which, regardless, is going to take education, right? It's going to take you having to learn something, some sort of education, right? So I like that. I like that, girl. Good job, girl. God is a God who cares about all the details of your life. Yeah. And he wants to give you power to overcome and use his strength to go through things. Did you know that God, the scripture says that he knows the number of hairs that is on your head, right? The number of hairs that's on your head, like some of y'all got a lot of hair, right? Like, I don't know, there has to be billions of strands of hair. If he cares to know the number of strands of hair that is on your head, don't you think he cares about the other details of your life? Don't you think if the scripture says that he wants to give you everything that's for life and godliness? Did you know that your hair is dead? These are dead cells. And if God cares about the dead cells, don't you think he cares about the living problems that you have? Big or small, he cares about the small details that are in your life. And he wants his power to help you overcome those things. It could be, somebody was saying last service, like anger, right? Anger was a problem that somebody's like, yo, I need God's help with anger. Anybody else you need help? Like, I knew it. Uh-huh. It's all right. Ain't nothing wrong with, you know, admitting that. It's good. You have to admit it, right? Anybody else you need help with anger? Some of y'all just don't want to. Okay, good. Some people need help with the power of God for life when it comes to low self-esteem. Like, some people need help with low self-esteem. Like, man, I just really don't feel like. Some of you all didn't raise your hand when I said to be successful or do great things in life because you really don't think that you can. And that's something that God's power wants to help you with. God wants to help lift you up in that area as well. Some of you all, you need God's power to help you because you're prideful. You think that you just hot popping, you all that, right? And the Lord is like, nah, you need my help because you popping, but you ain't that popping, right? And so we really want to get to a point where we're using God's power for everything in life. Then it says this, verse 4, by which we have been given to us exceedingly great precious promises, that through these you may be partakers of the divine nature, escape the corruption that is in the world through lust. The scripture says that he wants to give us power to escape the world that we live in today, like the corruption of this world. We talked a little bit about that last week. How many people feel like the world is just like getting dark, right? It's getting dark. It's getting evil. Like, things are getting strange out here, right? And it kind of is low-key, you know? Like, people are really concerned with, like, AI and, like, what's about to happen in the future. iRobot is about to be a real thing in real life. Like, how are we, you know, like, and people are worried about the corruption that is in the world with our government, with all type of things that are going on, right? But the scripture says that he will give us, be partakers of his divine nature to overcome the corruption that is in the world through lust. This is one of my favorite scriptures that I'm about to read. And I just feel like it's really powerful because I don't think we realize the power that we have access to. And this is what 1 John 4:4 says. I'm not going to read the other parts. It says this. ye are of God, little children. He's talking to people that are of God. You know, everybody's not a child of God, right? Y'all know that, right? It's quiet. Did everybody know that everybody's not a child of God? You know, Jesus told some people that were in the church, literally like Pharisees and Sadducees, they were in the church, and Jesus said, your father is the devil. And so, like, not everybody's a child of God. Just because you're a human doesn't mean you're a child of God, right? You have to be born of God, which means you have to be born again, which means you have to have his. What makes somebody a child of God is simple. It's really simple. Either his spirit lives on the inside of you, or the devil's spirit lives on the inside of you, right? God's spirit wants to dwell on the inside of you, right? Does that mean that you're going to be completely perfect? Absolutely not. One day you will, right? When we get new bodies, you know, when we get the new heaven and the new earth, right? But, yeah, hey, Caleb's like, yeah, I'm looking forward to that, right? I like that, my boy, I like that. But right now, no. But the thing is this, everybody's not a child of God. And a lot of times you can look at people's actions to see are they children of God or not. Let's keep on moving on, right? It says in verse 4, ye are of God, little children, and have overcome them, because greater is he that is in you than he that is in the world. I want you all to say that with me, starting at because on three, okay? One, two, three. Stop. I need it a little louder. I need a little more people saying it, and I need y'all to learn how to read, all right? It says because, all right? Because it's a little tongue twister, I'm not going to lie. Because greater is he that is in you than he that is in the world. Let's do it one more time on three. One, two, three. Because greater is he that is in you. Stop. Now look to your neighbor and say, in you. No, look to him. Look to somebody and say, in you. In you. Greater is he, and this is talking about God. Greater is God, the God that is in you, than he who is in the world. Y'all know this? Yeah, which is the enemy. You all know the scripture says that the devil roams around like a roaring. Thank you, my boy. The devil roams around as a roaring. Okay, the scripture says that the devil roams around as a roaring lion, seeking who he may devour. So it says that our enemy, the devil, is like going around looking. He's like going out like a lion, seeking who he can devour. The scripture is saying, greater is the God that is in you than he who is in the system that's trying to take us out. Our God is so much bigger than the darkness that's in. Light is much bigger than darkness. Light is much bigger than darkness, and we can prove that every. Turn them lights off real quick. Can you turn them off real quick? Oh, man, can y'all still see? Is it as many lights on? No, it's not as many lights, but one. Can you turn these lights off? Huh? Can we have service with no lights on, period? So everybody can be asleep? Absolutely not. Absolutely not. Y'all think I'm stupid, right? Oh, like this, huh? Like this? Oh, right? Y'all wanted to be like the club. I got you. Can you turn that light off? Turn that light off. You. Yeah. Turn that one off. It's a little switch right over there. Yeah, right there. Go on. You tall. Okay. Man. Can you all still see? Can you all still see? Seriously. Wow. Yo, get off the mic. So the thing is this, right? The little bit of light that we have in this room still outpowers darkness. The little bit of light that we have in the room still outpowers the darkness that is in this room. Light is stronger than darkness. The purple is kind of fire like this, right? It is kind of fire. You can turn the plug sign, turn the lights back on though, because people watching online, they can't see. They can't see online, all right? Oh, like a vampire. I'm burning, right? That light right there is like, is it always that bright? Good night. And the reason the light is hurting some of you all's eyes is because Jesus is the light. And some of you all ain't spending no time with Jesus. So when you see the righteousness, nah, let me stop. But the thing is this, light is stronger than darkness. And so if God is light and the world is dark, a little bit of light goes a long way. You all ever heard that saying, go to the light at the end of the, right? You can see the light at the end of the tunnel and you know that's the direction that you need to go on. When light is shown up anywhere, that's what people are attracted to. And so if our light is not shining, how are people going to be attracted to us? This little light of mine, I'm going to let it shine. Oh, I'm going to let it shine. Stop. Wait, who was that? That sounded good. I hate that song. I ain't gonna lie. It's probably one of the worst songs that they have out for children. Because it's not a little light. The light that we have is not little at all. The light that we have is actually really big and really powerful. If you think your light is just little, how are you gonna go into dark places with a little light? I ain't going nowhere with no little light. We got a big light that dwells on the inside of us. Oh. All right. But what we want to do is this. The only thing that makes the light shine bright is the power that's under the light, which is like the wick of the candle, which is AKA the Lord, right? Like the oil, which is like the Holy Spirit, right? And he's not little at all. It's actually really, really big and bright. But greater is he that is in you. You, than he that is in the world. In you too, bro. Greater is he that's in you all than he that's in the world. And that's very powerful. That's something that you really need to understand, that there is power that you have access to, but you need to tap into it. You have something you had to say? Wanted to say? Where the mic runner at? Mic runner, run.
I was actually just thinking about this a lot this week on like how silly it is to live by our own strength and power when we can access the power of God who created everything. You know, it's like, why would I choose this weaker power of myself?
Right,
when I tell myself, oh, I'm not going to do this, and I do it, I'm not powerful. I tell myself, okay, yeah, I'm strong enough not to fall into these temptations, and I do it. So that proves that I'm not very powerful. I'm not, in my own strength, there's a weakness that I have. And yet, I can access, as a child of God, I have the right to access the power of God. Why would I choose myself?
Yeah.
When there's a greater level of power. You know, I was just thinking about this week, like, yo, I'm good. I'm going to choose the power of God.
Yeah,
Whatever I need to do, if I need to pray more, if I need to study more, if I need to connect with him in my spirit more, I'm going to choose that over myself.
Yeah, I like that a lot. It's crazy not to. It's crazy not. Why wouldn't you? Why wouldn't? Right. Thank you, Brian. Pride is what it is. Right. Pride is what it is. You think that you're good on your... You think you're on your own. You think you could do it, right? The scripture says this, Proverbs 6, that God tells us that we should sometimes study nature to learn about life lessons. So Proverbs 6 says this, go to the ant, you sluggard. Consider her ways and be wise, right? Like, he just came out the gate. Go to the ant, you sluggard. Consider her ways and be wise. He's saying that. Go study this and be wise. Go study this situation. Study how ants work. Anybody ever study ants? Anybody ever study how ants work? Yo, ants have like a very, okay, I was about to nerd out, but ants have like a really amazing social structure in how they live. Like, they're really phenomenal. Like, you should go watch some ant anybody watch documentaries on like nature and stuff like that? Some of y'all? Yeah, Ants the Movie was good, but that's not what we're talking about. We're talking about, like, real documentaries, like, not Disney. But it says, go to the ant and learn their ways. I want you all to check out this this video really quickly, and just pay attention to this. This is interesting.
Back to the nest before they also die.
Think of them things crawling on.
But they've strayed into a minefield. Each of these strange cone-shaped pits is a death trap. With a brutal predator at its center. Here lie antlion larvae. Tiny ambush predators with venom-filled pincers.
That thing going ham on the ant, so I ain't gonna lie.
Some ants manage to escape. But the antlion has other tricks. Flinging sand into the air, it creates an avalanche. In this cone of death, the walls are so angled that the sand slips beneath the ant's feet. As boulders rain from the sky, escape seems almost impossible.
My man escape, right? Huh? Oh, yeah. Anytime I watch TV, I don't watch TV like that, but when I watch TV, I watch. You can ask my wife. So what that was an antlion. An antlion larvae that set up a trap. And at the bottom of the trap, the antlion was there buried, hidden, where you couldn't see it. And while that was going on, the ants would fall in and you all saw what was happening, right? You all saw that from there. That is a very good question. Now, I want you to, did you hear what he said? He said, why didn't they just walk around? Why didn't they just walk around and play the video real quickly and turn it down some? Because I want to go through this some for you all to kind of see a couple of things that was going on. That's a wise question. Why didn't they go around? Oftentimes in life, the enemy, our enemy has set up traps for us, right? That we're not aware that it's an actual trap. We're not aware that it's something that can entrap us, that can enslave us, that can mess us up in life. Press pause for me real quick. So we're going through life normal. Like the ants were looking for food. That's what they were doing. And as they're looking for food, they're going through life and just normally minding their business. But these ant lions were all around. It was a whole, you all saw it was a bunch of traps, right? You all saw it was a bunch of them. It was multiple of them out there. Yeah, they're trying to eat them, right? And what they end up doing is they catch them, they suck out all the juice that's on the inside of them, and then they throw their bodies out, right, of the pit, which is like really crazy, right? So they just be flinging dead bodies out of their pit, right? Bro, you got a lot of questions, huh? Where's the mic at? Ask your question out loud because there's people online.
I said, how with the ants and lion, how is the ant lion made of like ants and not like the ant lion?
What? Oh. Yeah, they just call it an ant lion. Yeah, yeah, they just, because it attacks ants, right? That's the only, because it's like trying to, it's just a predator, right? That's just what they call it. Yeah, I got you, I got you. So, the thing is, you had a, over here, real quick.
I see like the ants when they're like looking for food or going through their journey. I see it as like a car going on a road, and then there's like these potholes. And sometimes you can swerve around them, but there's like a risk. You could like crash, or other times you just go over them, but you have to know how to recover and keep going on your journey.
Ah, I like that as well. That's solid. That's solid. And so as we are going through life, right, our enemy, the scripture says, be not aware of the enemy's devices. Be aware of the enemy's devices. Be aware of his traps. Be aware of the pitfalls that are around you. Be aware of what's going on. A lot of us, we're not aware that we're going through life and there's things that are set up for us to fail. And I'm not talking about any type of like, oh, because I'm black or because I'm a minority. Not them type of traps, right? Like, that's petty. We live in Atlanta, Georgia, right? It is mainly African Americans here, right? It's mainly, like, we ain't got no excuses, right? Blame yourself. Anyway, what we have to do is this. I got a question. Actually, I have a question. What are some areas in life that we can see that are areas that are set up for us to fall in and be trapped? What are some areas in life that can be set up that we can fall in and be trapped? Let me get Erica right there. Is it on? You gotta make sure you have it on for her. Who had their hands up over here? Eli, can you get Lauren over here? I got you already. All right, get her real quick while we try to figure that out.
Hello?
Yes, we can hear you.
I'll say the wrong environment.
The wrong environment. Talk to me about that. Talk to me.
Like, raised in the hood, wrong people.
Okay, I like that. So being raised in the wrong environment can cause you, like, yeah, because there's lots of pitfalls, a lot of traps that are around. Now, I want you to expound a little more, right? Like, what are some of the traps that are in that environment?
I would say drugs, alcohol, prostitution, stealing, all of that.
Okay. Yeah, right. Everything that's on music videos. All right, cool. Right? but that's a very, very valid point right there. I like that a lot, right? Yeah, that's good. Your environment can have those areas that are set up for you. If you ever notice in the hood, they'd be having more potholes anyway than like good areas. Anyway, go on.
Hello. Different obvious lust traps.
Say that again.
Lust traps.
Lust traps. Yeah. Like, give me some examples if you don't mind.
Like songs these days. And
school
related activities.
Okay, I got you. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Song, even movies that you watch. Right, even just sometimes commercials online, right? Just commercials, ads and stuff sometimes. Let me get him right there, and then, yeah, go first.
I would say, like, in school, because there's more chances for you to, like, fail than succeed sometimes, because if you don't work hard enough for, like, what you want to, like, pass and stuff, it's going to be, a harder way for you to get to, like, where you want to be, like, for college or jobs.
Okay, so, wait, don't get the mic up yet. I got a question, follow-up question. So you're saying, like, in school, like, not doing what you need to do or being difficult, like, what is the actual trap, though?
Like, hanging around the wrong people. Like, in class, if you're goofing around, you won't get your work done, or you get distracted and you fail something because you weren't paying attention enough or you didn't get the right notes for something that you need to pass.
Yeah, so, like, distractions of people can be a trap. And then as well, just like sometimes it's just pure laziness can be a trap, right? That's why the scripture say, go to the ant, you sluggard, right? You lazy person, go to the ant. Get him in the back for me real quick and go on.
Probably like peer pressure and cliques and stuff, like the group of friends you hang around.
Oh, yeah, peer pressure for sure, for sure, for sure. And yeah, peer pressure and cliques can definitely be, but give him the mic back. But what type of traps can you fall into? I want you all to dig a little deeper. What kind of traps can you fall into because of peer pressure or cliques?
Vaping, addiction, doing bad things, inappropriate things, and like trying to follow your friends.
So you talk a little louder.
Trying to follow your friends so you can fit in and stuff.
Okay. Yeah. Even gossiping, yeah. Lying, sneaking out of the house, right? Going to parties that you know you don't need to be at, right? Those type of things, right? That's a very good point. Going in the back.
Social media.
Social media can be a trap. Explain. Give me some. I want to dig a little deeper. What are the traps within social media?
You know, people posting about their lives. You could want to covet that stuff. Lust. It's a lot. It's a lot. On social
media. No, it is a lot within it. But yeah, covetousness, lust, ego.
Wasting your time on social media.
Yeah, that's wasting time. Yeah. And these things can end up being traps that you can get locked into long term. So, for example, let's keep on playing the video some. Play that a little more for me. So you see, it fell into the trap, and then what was ever at the bottom for it that it did not know was there ended up catching them and slamming them several times, right? The enemy oftentimes is waiting for us to fall into traps so that he can get a hold on us. The scripture calls it a stronghold. The scripture calls it like an area where now it's very difficult to get out of the jaws of whatever it is that they have it by. If you could press pause really quickly, right? So, for example, for me, just a personal, when I was younger, I used to have a problem with pornography. Right? Like, I used to have a problem with porn. I used to have a problem. And I would do well. Certain times I would go home, I would be by myself, and I would tell myself, like, I'm not going to do that today. I'm not doing that today. Right? And then I would end up falling into the trap. And then after I fell into the trap, now I'm feeling horrible, like, man, I can't believe I did that again, Nehemiah. That's so stupid. You just said you wouldn't. Blah, 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 blah. And sometimes I would go strong for, like, 4 days. Right? Like, I'm doing really good. I'm trying to climb out. And then all of a sudden, something triggered it. Something happened, right? Whether it was a friend that showed me something on their phone, whether it was I'm at school and my eyes are wandering and I'm looking at stuff that I don't need to look at. Or maybe we didn't have social media back then. We had something called MySpace. You ever heard of MySpace? Yeah, it was like really lame too. It was kind of fire, low key. It was kind of fire. But that was like the first social media out, right? That was one of them anyway. So we didn't have that where like you would get tempted on social media, but things would get me tempted and I would fall into the temptation. And it's like while I'm trying to get out, it would be difficult to get out. Anybody understand what I'm saying? Like you're trying to stop something, you're trying to get over something, and you're trying, and like you're really trying. But it's like it's just loose sand, and you're not really making a whole bunch of traction to go up, but you're trying really hard. Sometimes, did you know that life is not about the harder you work, the further you'll be in life? Sometimes it's not about just working hard. Sometimes you can be working hard on the wrong aspect, on the wrong thing. You can be working. I'm trying. Ain't nobody outworking me. Ain't nobody. But you're working on the wrong stuff. So you're not actually going towards the goal that you need to. Some of you all work hard to stop. And you're watching a whole bunch of videos. You're watching things on how to get over stuff. But you're not working hard in the spirit. When you work hard in the spirit, you can get traction to get you to go up. Let's keep on playing that song. It's the power of God. It's the power, his divine nature, which is that same power. And so Now then, after that happens, then the enemy starts to bring up other little tricks. He tries to bring your friends to show you something, and so you're trying to get out, but it's other things that keep on coming your way. It could be a family member that triggers you to get angry, and you know you shouldn't have got angry that time, and you've been working on it, right? But ultimately, the power of God is able to help us succeed when most don't succeed in that area. Most ants that get caught into a lion, that get caught into an ant lion's den, don't get out. Most of them die. It's a high majority of them that die. But God wants us to be the ones that are successful, we are able to get out through his power. I got a hand up over here, Mike Runner. Eli, run.
I would say a really popular trap is like your emotions, one of the higher emotions, like anger, that could cause you to like, because like anger is something that you have whenever you feel like something's not going right or your way or other things where it tempts you to just blow up. And sometimes that happens to me too, where I just feel like giving myself angry and instead of blowing up, just go into like my own space to just try to calm myself down instead of taking out other people, because then it can cause a huge thing to happen, which is ain't good.
Yeah, facts. And so oftentimes too, something about anger is a secondary emotion, right? So the anger may show up, but the primary emotion is deep underneath. Maybe, so when me and Eliza, right, we're married, and a lot of times when I would get really upset and angry about something, maybe because I was hurt on how something hurt my feelings, right? And because that hurt my feelings, it causes me to get angry. Or it could be, it's always a secondary emotion. It's always something else that causes you to get angry. Like my cousin used to always get angry if we called him stupid, right? He would get like pissed if somebody called him stupid. I'm not stupid. Who are you talking to, right? But the reason he would get so angry about that, because he really had low self-esteem and felt like he was stupid, so it hurt him when somebody would call him stupid, so he would respond in anger. Does that make sense? Does that make sense what I'm saying? So a lot of times when you get angry over something, you should really sit back and ask the Lord, like, why am I really angry right here, Lord? What is really going on that this is causing me to be angry? Is it because I'm hurt? Is it because I'm sad? Is it because I'm just, what is it that's going on? And sometimes, afraid, little touchy subject, but even sometimes ladies, you need to, check and see what time of the month it is as well. Like, is this causing me to be emotionally strong right now, right? And then you need to go to the Lord about trying to get that in check as well, too. Amen? No amens. All right, cool. Thank you. All right, never mind. Let's keep on moving. Let me keep on moving. Wow. That's right? That time? Okay. All right, let's go through this quickly. We serve a God who is able to deliver us from the lion's den, who's able to deliver us from the pit of whatever type of lion it may be, an ant lion or a real lion, right? Or in the scripture, it talks about the lion, which is like the enemy, right? The enemy, and he's able to deliver us from it. Anybody familiar with Daniel's in the lion's den? Who's read that story? No, not heard it. Like, who's read it in the Bible? Who's read it? Okay, a couple of you all? Okay, cool. Who hasn't? Who doesn't know what I'm talking about? Like, honestly, thank you. Who doesn't know? Y'all don't know? Okay? Cool. I'm going to read this story to you all. I'm going to kind of get my own version and skip some things, but I want you all to pay attention to this story. Daniel was in captive. He was like a slave. He got captured and started living in a different country. And while he was living in his different country, he ended up rising to the top. He was ended up like working in the government per se, and being like a high official person in the government, all right? So let's read about Daniel really quickly. Daniel 6, verse 3. Then this Daniel distinguished himself above the governors, the satraps, because an excellent spirit was in him, and the king gave thought to set him over the home realm. Question, what distinguished Daniel from everybody else? Say it again. He had a what? He had an excellent spirit. Thank you. Hey, bro, you mad at me? Okay, cool, cool. Just making sure. Say it with your chest. I like it. He said, nah, bro, not at all. I'm just saying it. An excellent spirit. That's what made Daniel different and excelled. This is why the king wanted to make him ruler over the entire realm, because he was excellent. He had an excellent spirit. That spirit gave him power to become excellent. God gives us the ability for life and godliness, all things that pertain to life and godliness, okay? So, in order to excel in life, you need to be excellent, and you need that spirit of excellence within you. Some of you all need that when it comes to your sports, when it comes to your dance routines, when it comes to your schoolwork, when it comes to just washing the dishes at home. Like, some of you all need an excellent spirit. And so let's really pray real quick. Let's ask the Lord to help us, to give us an excellent spirit, all right? On three, we're going to pray, and I want you all to pray out. Like, open up your mouth and ask the Lord to help you in this area, okay? Three, two, one, pray. I can't hear you all praying. I want to hear you all, like, literally praying. Let's practice again. On three, and then I'm going to pray as well, but I want you all to start saying this out loud. On three. One, two, three. Go ahead and start praying. Dear Heavenly Father, Lord, I thank you that you have given me an excellent spirit. I thank you, dear Father God, that your word said that we can have a spirit of excellence like Daniel had, like Joseph had, so that we excel in everything that we do. No matter if it's we're a manager of a team, a manager at a store, if we're just managing things in our home, that we do excellence and that you distinguish us, that you set us apart because of the excellence that you have put inside of us, Lord. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen. This is a huge part about being successful. A lot of you all said y'all want to be successful, you want to be great. This is a big part of it, being excellent. Then it says this. So the governors and satraps sought to find some charge against Daniel concerning the kingdom, but they could find no charge or fault because he was, that was earlier, but good paying attention. This one says because he was faithful, right? Because he was faithful, nor was there any error, oh man, found in him. So anyway, what ended up happening was this. I'm good? Okay. To be faithful means what? What does it mean to be faithful? What does it mean to be faithful? Somebody else instead of Maddox. Who said that? Oh. Loyal. I like that. What else? Trustworthy. That's a good, solid one as well. What else? What does it mean to be faithful? What does it mean to be faithful? You. Yeah. What does it mean to be faithful? You know, I promise you know. Nah? Okay, what if I was to say that, this is my wife right here, right? What if I was to say, like, I'm unfaithful to her, right? Dang, yeah. So if I say I'm unfaithful to her, so if I end up saying I'm faithful to her, what does that mean? I'm asking her. Huh? What'd he say? That means I'm loyal to her, right? Like, I'm not stepping out. I'm not cheating on her. I'm faithful to her. So if it's saying that he was faithful in whatever work that he was doing, right, and whatever, everything that he was doing, he was being faithful to it. He was honest. He was trustworthy. He was not slacking in what he was doing. He was faithful to it, right? Now verse 9. They came to the king and they was like, yo, king, guess what? It was like, guess what, king? They was like, we want to make a law. And for 30 days, nobody should worship anybody else. They shouldn't pray to another god. They shouldn't worship nobody else but you for 30 days. And if anybody else does worship somebody else or pray to somebody else, we're going to throw them in the lion's den. So the king signed off on that, like, bet. I like that law. That sounds good to me. Signed off on it. Promised, like, you know what? No matter what, this is what's going to happen. How many of you all, if the king signed that law, if Joe Biden signed that law and said that, you know what, nobody should pray to anybody else for 30 days, how many people are going to be out praying in public? How many of you all feel like you'll be, thank you, my boy, I got a couple hands. Some of y'all don't pray in public now, so it's not hard to not do that. But some of you are like, okay, this is what your boy Daniel did. Listen to what Daniel did. This guy is wild. Now, when Daniel knew that the writing was signed, he went to the crib. And in his upper room, with his windows open towards Jerusalem, he knelt down on his knees 3 times a day and prayed and gave thanks before his God, as was his custom since early days. So there's a couple things we can take from that. Number one, Daniel was like, yo, this is my routine. This is what I always do. I've been doing, this is what ended up giving me the power, is because I stayed faithful to praying every single day, multiple times a day. I'm not about to stop that just because the king made a law. You know what? Bust these windows open. I want y'all all to see me praying, right? I mean, people feel like you're going to be down like Daniel. That's what you're doing, right? I'm not going to lie. I feel like I would probably just like, I'm going to still pray, but, you know, can I do it in my room? Like, can I do it in my room with nobody watching? I'm still praying, Lord, you see me. But Daniel was on a different level. Daniel was like, nah, like, I'm not going to be scared of nobody. I'm busting these windows open, and y'all going to see me praying. Verse 11, then these men assembled and found Daniel praying and making supplication before him, before his God. And they went before the king and spoke concerning the king. Like, yo, king, didn't we say this? Guess what? We found your boy Daniel praying. Time to throw him in the lion's den. All they was doing was they was hating on Daniel. They was trying to get him caught up, so they made a law that they knew he wasn't going to disobey. He was so faithful to God that they knew, like, the only thing that he's not going to mess up in is with his Lord and Savior. Like, so if we make a law that will do something like, then we can get him caught up. We can throw him in the lion's den, and then we can take his spot, right? So verse 18 says, now the king went to his palace and spent the night fasting, and he had no musicians were brought before him. This man had no music playing. He wasn't listening to Lil Yachty, no music playing at all. Yeah, the king had no music playing. Yeah, the king was like, you know what? I don't want this to happen, but the king couldn't overturn it because that was his word. He signed that that was going to happen. The king like, yo, I'm a fast. I'm not going to listen to no music, right? Also, his sleep went from him. Then the king arose very early in the morning and went at haste to the den of the lions. Where he came to the den, he cried out with a lamenting voice to Daniel. The king spoke, saying, Daniel, Daniel, servant of the living God, has your God, whom you serve continually, been able to deliver you from the lions? Yo, this is very interesting. This is how faithful, consistent Daniel was, that the king was like, yo, this God whom you always serving. Like, we know that everybody in the city know that you serve God. Is the God that you serve, the God that you represent, was he able to save you? This goes back to faithfulness. This goes back to consistency. This goes back to excellence in how Daniel operated. Everybody knew it. Verse 21, then Daniel said to the king, O king, live forever. My leg has been chopped off and eaten by a lion. Nah, that's not what it says at all. It says, my God sent his angel to shut up the lion's mouth so that they have not hurt me because I was found innocent before him. And also, O king, I've done no wrong before you. So this man was like, God's power was able to send an angel down and shut up a lion's mouth so it wasn't able to eat him. Question, have any of you all seen a lion in real life? Who's seen a lion in real life, like at a zoo? Yo, lions are huge. Lions are humongous, bro. To think about being thrown into a pit with multiple lions, I'm not going to lie, I would be terrified. Like, multiple, if it's one lion, it's like, I may be able to win if I had a knife somewhere, but multiple lions, right? God's power was able to get him out of the den where it was multiple enemies, multiple things that he could have been entangled, ensnared, killed, hurt by, and God was able to help him in that area. Now the king was exceedingly glad for him and commanded that they should take Daniel out of the den. So Daniel was taken up out of the den. No injury whatever was found on him because he believed in his God. Yo, this is the type of faith that you need to have when you're in a situation. Believing so much in your God, believing that he's going to get you out of it. Daniel was confident. He had faith. He trusted that God was going to get him out of the situation, and he ended up dead. If you look at your situation and think, I'm always going to have anger. I'm always going to have lust. I'm always going to struggle with this. You always will. But if you have the mindset of God is going to deliver me from this, God is going to cause me to be excellent. God is going to cause me to be great in this world. God is going to cause me to overcome this addiction. God is going to cause me to do these things. Guess what? Now you're putting your faith in his power and what he can do for you. God is going to cause me to be healed of whatever it is that I'm sick from. God, that is you putting your faith in his power. And that's when he's able to actually do some work. He can't do no work if you don't put no faith in him. If you don't put any trust or faith in him, there's not a lot of work that he can do. You got it. Those that come to God must believe that he is and that he's a rewarder of them that diligently seek him. So some people may think, well, you know, the lions just wasn't hungry. It's just a coincidence. The lions weren't hungry. They didn't really want to eat nothing. So they didn't want to eat no human. That's why, you know, they didn't get eaten or whatever because they wasn't really hungry. Well, let's keep on reading. Verse 24. And the king gave to the command, and they brought those men who have accused Daniel, and they cast them into the lions, them, their children, and their wives. And the lions overpowered them and broke all of their bones in pieces before they ever came down to the bottom of the den. It means like as they were lowering them down, the lions started tearing them apart. And so it's like, yo, but why did they throw their children in the den? Right? Like that's a little messed up. Like, yo, why you have to throw the children? Why'd you have to throw the children in the den along with them? You have an answer? Oh, I'm interested to see your answer.
Because when parents tell children, let me say it like this. Children look up to their parents, and children will automatically listen to their parents unless they know if that's not right. And even if they know that's not right, they will sometimes they will not do the things that aren't right, but other times they will still listen because they're their parents and they will think that the parents are trying to do something bad to them.
I follow, right? So it's like, I follow. So like they can follow a bad trend, right? If their parents is doing evil stuff and they end up doing that, right? One of the reasons this is key, especially for the fellas in this room, I really want you fellas, this is true for the ladies as well, but fellas, listen up. One of the things that is very true is that your actions affect your children. They affect your entire family. And so some of you are like, well, I ain't married right now. I ain't got no children. No, your actions right now actually affect your children. Your actions right now actually affect the future in other people's lives. If you make good decisions now, that can positively affect your children. If you make negative decisions now, that can negatively affect your children. Anybody heard of generational curses? Y'all heard of generational curses? That's like a curse that multiple people in that generation have dealt with, right? For example, there's some generational curse, like alcoholism can be a generational curse. The great-great-grandfather was an alcoholic. The grandfather was an alcoholic. Your father was an alcoholic. And now it's coming up on you, right? And so that's a generational curse. And those were made because of the decisions of other people. Now, how many people in this room, like, you know family members, if we could just be open a little bit, candid a little bit, honest, just within the room, who in this room feel like you know in your family lineage there's, like, alcoholism within your family, right? A lot of you all's hands went up. Okay, what about, like, drugs? Like, that's a normal thing for drugs to be within your family. What about this? What about multiple of the women have children and they're not married? That's a normal thing within the family, right? That's a normal thing, right? So listen, if you notice those things within your family, I think it is very foolish for somebody to then, if you know alcoholism is a trap that is in your family generation, why would you ever drink alcohol? You're already predisposed to that. Why would you ever do it? If you recognize that all the women, all the men, you know, your dad got a lust issue, your granddaddy got a lust issue, why would you even want to have sex outside of marriage? If these traps are here, why are you going into the trap? Why don't you, just like my boy said earlier, why don't you just go around that thing? It's just common sense. Like, if you got, your family got an issue with drugs, why would you ever think about smoking weed? Why would you think about it? Well, because we don't see the traps. We're not aware. We're not thinking of the traps, right? And so it's really easy for us to say, bro, why ain't these ants are stupid? Just go around the trap, bro, right? Stupid little ant, right? And we got all types of things going on in our family, and yet we still doing things. You know, why? Just go around the trap, stupid. Don't be an idiot. Just go around the trap, right? And it can really be that simple. But if you do get caught up, the power of God can help you go around the trap, and the power of God can get you out of the trap. And then I'm going to close, and then I know you got your hand up. Is this. The beautiful thing about generational curses, the opposite side is generational blessings. And when you become a child of God, the same power and benefits that come from God can now be passed on to you. So just like a generational curse, it's like, man, it's a high opportunity for you to get caught up in this if you do this. With a generational blessing, it's the same thing. Man, it's a high opportunity since God is now our Father and He was able to, you know, live a life of purity. Man, it's a high potential that you can live that same type of life as well. You got this, turn it on.
It's kind of like a question, but like it's for like drugs and stuff like that, like throughout family. What if they found like what if there was like stuff going on in their family and then they found something to like escape it, and then it keeps moving like that where things keep happening and people keep doing it, and it's like an escapism type thing for them. So it's kind of like a question, but what if that's why the next generation keeps you, if stuff keeps happening?
Yeah. And actually, that's a reason why a lot of people get into those type of things in general, because it's a way of escape. You don't want to have to deal with, life is so tough, life is so hard, you know? Man, I ain't going to lie, man, I'm so stressed out. I got so much going on. I just need a little hit of something to escape the reality of what's really going on. Right? And that is a real reason why people do it. However, you're going to the wrong source. Yeah. drugs shouldn't be your source of getting away and escaping. That's going to end up getting you trapped. Instead of that, because I hate that stupid excuse. It's one of the stupidest things that people be saying, right? Like, I mean, it just, weed just calms my anxiety. So now you're going to be addicted to something and need something and body always desire. Don't you think that's a little worse than just anxiety? Like, and most people end up having, most males have higher anxiety when they smoke than when they don't smoke. This is a proven statistic for young males that smoke loud. Like, that's proven. Anyway, so, yes, people do it for that, but it's the wrong reason, right? And so if you know that that's the reason, you got to realize, okay, they did that, I got to do something different. And maybe my escape needs to be, maybe it's talking to somebody that's more wiser than me. Maybe it's reading the word of God. Maybe it's praying during that moment. Maybe it's, you know, worshiping. Maybe it's dancing. Maybe it's working out, you know. Maybe it's doing somebody's hair. Who knows what it can be, but you got to find something else. But ultimately, you got to go to God for that situation. But what I'm talking about today, like the power that comes with escaping through these traps that the world has set out so that we don't get caught up, that power is only for people who have the Spirit of God. This is only for children of God, right? To have that full access to what we're talking about is through the Lord. And so just with every head bowed and every eye closed really quickly. If you've never accepted Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior, that is the way into tapping into this power. Jesus says that I am the way, I am the truth, I am the life. No man comes into the Father but through me. What it is this. Jesus is the way. And you need his Spirit to dwell within you. If that is you in this room right now and you've never accepted Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior, and you desire to, you feel like the Lord is calling you, you feel like there's a yearning, there's something that you want to do. If you could, just lift your hands for me real quickly, and we would love to pray for you. If you might have come to church before. It's a difference between coming to church and accepting Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior. That's you. Can you lift your hands for me real quickly? You want to accept Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior. You've never done that before. Just lift your hands. Then there may be people in this room, yeah, you have accepted Jesus Christ, but now you want to come back to him. You've been slipping. You've been falling into the trap. You're going a total different way, a total different direction, and you know you're living wrong. That's you, and you want to start living right and living for him again. You want to plug back into him. Could you lift your hands for me really quickly? That is you in this room. You just want to come back to him and start living for him. Just lift your hands for me real quickly. Then there may be some people in this room that it's just like, you know, I love the Lord, but I feel like something's missing. And maybe it's a power that you're missing. And that is going to be the power of God. And that comes through his Spirit. So if you want to receive the Holy Spirit, the evidence of speaking in tongues, if that is you today and you desire to speak in another tongue, can you just lift your hands for me as well? Then lastly, if you just need prayer for anything, it could be prayer because you're struggling with something. It could be prayer because you need the Lord's power to help you in the situation. It could be prayer because you got finals coming up and you're really stressed and nervous. It could be prayer for healing in your body, prayer to get free from a demon. If that is you and you desire that prayer, just lift your hands for me really quickly. I see that hand over there. Anybody else you need, just prayer for anything. we would love to pray for you. In Jesus, Lord, we thank you right now in the name of Jesus for each and every single person that is in this room. Lord, I pray that your spirit does a mighty work, that your presence, dear Father God, falls heavily on each and every single person in this room. Help us to desire the things of you more than the things of this world. Help us to desire spiritual gifts, dear Father God. Help us to desire to grow, to develop in the things of you, that we tap into your power, Lord. For each and every single person in this room, Lord, that may be struggling with any type of bondage, Lord, I bind it up in the name of Jesus and ask that you give them freedom right now in Jesus' name. I thank you that your power, dear Father God, gives them the strength to overcome. Thank you, Lord, that because you have overcome the world, we can overcome the world. Thank you that greater are you who lives in us than the world system, that we don't have to be bound by it. We honor you today. We thank you. We love you. In Jesus' name we pray. If you are in this room right now, just with every head bowed and eyes closed, and you did raise your hand, maybe it was for prayer, rededication, whatever it may be. If that is you and you just desired that prayer, what I want you to do is this. If you could just stand up for me really quickly, and we're just going to take you to the back and pray for you. Yeah, we're just going to pray for you in the back. It's going to be nothing embarrassing. So if that is you and you desire prayer, you desire salvation, you desire rededication, or the Holy Spirit, just stand up for me real quick, and we're just going to pray for you in the back. Thank you, Lord. We honor you today. We love you. We care deeply about you. You are good, merciful, and kind. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. 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 Alrighty, alrighty, alrighty. Y'all got anything from today? Nah? All right, cool. I'll try better next week. really quick, we got a couple side announcements. A couple side announcements real quick that we have for you all, and then we're going to get on out of here. Yo, we got our first kickback this year going on, our Grill and Chill. Our Grill and Chill, which is going to be going on Friday, 5/26. So make sure you sign up for our Grill and Chill. Yes, there's the Grill and Chill. Sign up for that. If you've never been to one before, who likes to eat? Okay. Who likes to play games? Who likes to have fun? All right, cool, cool, cool. Well, this is the place that you need to be. We're going to be playing all type of games. We got dodgeball going on. We got card games. We got spoons. We got board games, we got food, we got activities, we got football, we got all type of stuff, man. Make sure you come out. It's going to be the 26th, I think it's, that's a Friday. Of course, it ain't, yeah, it's a Friday night. Come out, enjoy, get some free food, have a good one. Somebody wants to sponsor? Okay, just let me know. All right, I need to know who, just let me know who. Yeah. All seniors, who's a senior in the room? If you're a senior, where the seniors at? We got one senior? You ain't no senior. A senior, stand up for me if you're a senior. Stand up. If you're a senior, you're a senior over here too. Stand up for me. Yeah, man. Yeah. Good, good, good. Yo, we got a couple things going on. Number one, for all the seniors, graduation Sunday is coming up. And so make sure you sign up. That's going to be June 4th. We're going to have like a little reception. Wear your cap and gown, okay? Wear your cap and gown. We're going to have a little reception, have some food and stuff like that for you, okay? We want to celebrate you, honor you. Number two, if you're a senior, we got a senior trip going on. I guess more seniors attend first service than second service. But what we got a senior trip. We're going to Tennessee overnight. It's going to be fun. We're going whitewater rafting. We're going horseback riding. It's going to be like a good little trip. You don't want to miss it. So make sure you all sign up for that. As well, the senior trip is going to be on 6/9 through 6/10, all right? The price is only $49, all right? It's only $49. And then, who went to Power Trip last year? Who went on Power Trip last year? Okay, okay. Who didn't go? Who didn't go? Raise your hand if you didn't go. Yo, you missed out. You missed out. You missed out. And so we having it again. We going to Jekyll Island. Who needs to get away from their parents? Dang, it's too many hands. Too many hands going up. Dang, too many parents. Too many hands going up for that. But listen, listen. If you want to get away for about 3 days, four nights, no, four days, three nights, make sure you come on a power trip, all right? We're going to Jekyll Island. We're going to have a good time. Who's going to the, anybody been to Jekyll Island before? All right, well, you was there. If you was there last year, all right, for the first time, yeah. And so we're going to have a good time out there. We got some good activities, and then we got some time just for you all to kind of just, like, chill, relax, right? Have some, yeah, relax on the beach this time, all right? So it's going to be really, really fun. Make sure you sign up for that. And I think that's all. Okay, I think that's all the announcements we have. We do have somebody's birthday today. And so we got a birthday girl with the fresh braids in the back with the pink on. Listen, who else's birthday is this month? Who else's birthday is this month? Boy, put your hand down. It was. I forgot. My bad. I was trying to say, though, whose birthday is coming up? Whose birthday is coming up? Nah? All right. Can we sing you happy birthday? Yeah? Can you stand up? All right, cool. Madison's going to start off. Stand up, Madison. Start it off. Go on. Madison's going to start it off, and we're going to sing. What's your name, baby girl? Huh? Yanaya? Lanaya. All right, her name's Lanaya, all right? You singing too, Sean? All right, go on. Lead it, Madison. Wait, which way are we doing? We doing regular or we doing the black style way? Okay. Hey, you're leading, Kirk Franklin. Let's go.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Maya. Happy birthday. And many more.
All right.
And any other first-time visitors here today? Oh.
Yo, we got some new merch. That's fire. You want to get this? The price is only $20. Pop something today. Scan the QR.
Oh, yeah, I forgot we got new merch, y'all. Y'all got to make sure y'all cop some merch. We got some plug shirts. Make sure you go cop them out in the front. They only $20, so make sure you go and get them. I forgot about that commercial. Any first-time visitors? You here for the very first time? Raise your hand. First time. Yeah, make some noise. Anybody else? Thank you so much for coming, my brother. Thank you so much. Service isn't out. Five guys right here, five girls right here. Let's go. Five guys over here, five guys. I need five. All right, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Let's go. I need five girls. Let's go. 1, 2. I need five smart girls. Smart. Okay, the rest of y'all. Okay, 3. Yeah. Boy, stop. Get over here. 4. One more. All the rest of y'all girls dumb? Y'all dumb. I'm just saying. Come on, Sarah. All right, 5. Two mics. Bring the mics up here. You all face each other?
Yes, it does.
Face each other? Face each other?
I'm Batman.
Nah, they're not math questions. All right. This is easy. This is a very simple game. This is how it's going to work. Come on, Summer. How it's going to work is like this. I'm going to give you a category. It's easy. I'm going to give you a category. If I give you the category of, give me an example. Give me a category, somebody. Pets. If I say pets, he's going to say bird.
Snake.
Right, back and forth. If you say you're out. If you take longer than 3 seconds, you're out. If, yes, like hesitation. It's like hesitation. It's like hesitation, right? Or if you say the same thing somebody else said, you're out. Okay? If the guys win, I got something for all the fellas. If the girls win, I got something for all the girls. If you lose, you go to the back. Okay? Huh? Oh, yeah. Make sure you remind me about that. All right? All right. Let's go. Give me a category.
Cereal.
Dog breed.
Food? I heard food. Let's do... Okay. I got one. Okay. We're going to do ice cream flavors on three. One, two, three.
Chocolate.
Mint ice cream.
Strawberry.
Rocky Road.
Wait. Yeah, y'all did. Y'all both said
No. Okay, he said one first, though.
Yeah. No, but they said
He said first.
Yeah, you all both said it. You all both. All right.
Okay, he said one first,
that was a practice round. Practice round. All right. Let's go. Dang it. I would be out, too. Let's do cereal on three, starting with you. Three, two, one, go.
Cinnamon Toast Crunch.
Out. Good job, Cinnamon Toast Crunch. Next. All right. Nuh-uh. Next.
Nah,
she just goes to the back. That's easy. Shoe brands is easy. Okay, I got it. Football teams.
Uh-oh. No, I'm out.
One. Oh my goodness. That's a really good one. Like, what are you?
Why that's unfair? I don't know nothing.
All right. Your first sports on three. One, two, three.
Wrestling.
Lacrosse.
Basketball.
Spike ball.
Wrestling.
Out. Said wrestling two times? One to one.
Is it still sports?
Nah, the first one was a practice round. 1-1. All right. Let's do. Which one? Oh, I got one. Okay. We're doing candy on three. One, two, three.
Jolly Ranchers.
Twizzlers.
Oh, bro. Y'all, come on. Can somebody do it? Man, that was horrible. All right. We're doing animals on three. No. I'm sorry. We're doing... animals in the ocean on three. One, two, three.
Octopus.
Fish.
Shark.
Dolphin.
Crab.
Whale.
Shrimp. Squid.
Ow, man. That was close. What's the score? 3-1. Now you lost. No, you're the only one that won.
Two to three, my bad.
2-3. All right, let's do... What? No. All right, I got it. Okay. States on three. States in America, starting with you. 1, 2, 3.
Alaska.
Georgia.
Bro, what are y'all doing, fellas? It's not that hard.
Yes,
Alaska is a state in America.
I thought it was a country. My bad.
Yo, she just said she thought Alaska was a country. Alaska is a state in America. What do you mean?
Why is it off and over there?
Because America bought it, well, stole it from people. All right, let's...
Don't do nothing harsh.
All right, fine. Colors on three, starting with you. One, two, three.
Red.
Brown.
Black.
Red. White.
Oh, my goodness! Summer, is it really that hard?
I said red.
And red was already said. I know, she's out. Man, boy, what's the score?
It's
3-4, okay. Bro, this is not that hard. Okay, let's do... It's not hard. I would definitely beat her. You, if I played you, I would beat you. And I beat you, too. I would definitely beat you. Tripping, babe. All right, shoe brands on three. Shoe brands on three, starting with you. One, two, three, go. Point. All right, 4-4. 4-4. Last one, let's go. Next people, let's go, let's go. Last one. Let's go, let's go. Duh, this is easy. Books of the Bible. One, two, three.
Genesis.
Exodus.
Leviticus.
What? Wait, what did she say?
Out! She said Leviticus. It's not about what she said. Oh. Dang, that means the ladies won. Ladies won. Ladies, come see me. Baby, that's easy. Go. Give me a category. That's easy.
Yeah, you too.
Give me one. It's easy. Hurry up.
Stories of the Bible.
Stories of the Bible. No, not stories.
Countries. Yeah. Countries.
Huh?
Countries.
No. Countries?
No,
let's
countries.
Go.
Countries.
Caribbean. We could do Caribbean.
We're American. No, we're not doing that. Hurry up. Give me one.
Stories of the Bible.
Stories of the Bible? Yes. All right.
Daniel and the lion's den.
Jesus being born.
The Jesus.
I won. All right, fellas, we
Wait.
Won.
No, yeah. Wait, I wasn't ready.
But ladies, come on. Ladies, I got something for you if you want to get a prize.
Bye,
I got something for you.
Tell your mother happy Mother's Day from me and Nehemiah.
Go to arts call, you gotta kill all the hate. Never said it was easy, through Christ you can win. I don't stay with no glock, through the word I defend. Say a prayer for my brother who locked in the pen. This ain't dirty or mud in my double cup. This the holy water, they gon' fill you up. Got a clip with a strip on my hip.